Canada is recognized for many fantastic things, but what about its cuisine? For years, Canadian food has been unfairly mocked or simply ignored. Canada boasts a diverse range of weather, language, religion, politics, and of course, food. From the west coast of British Columbia to the east coast of New Brunswick, from the Prairies to the Highlands, from the Maritimes to metropolis Toronto and everything in between. Canada, the world's second largest country, is home to hundreds of diverse foods and traditions, and there's so much delicious food here that it might be overwhelming. Welcome to the Itinerant Traveler, and in this video, we scoured the Great White North for 9 Canadian dishes you simply must taste. We've skipped the obvious choices and focused solely on foods that are indigenous to Canada. But before we get into our list, be sure to subscribe and like our video to help our channel grow. Number 9. Tortillère. Tortillère is a meat pie that's emblematic of French-Canadian culture and entrenched in Quebecois tradition. It is a derivative of sipai, a traditionally British dish known as sea pie. The quality of the meat and spices used are important, with pork, beef, and veal being the most common meats used today. The pie is double-crusted and traditionally served during Christmas Eve or Réveillon. While there is no one correct recipe, the ritual and tradition of making and sharing tortillère with friends and family is what makes it an important and beloved Canadian dish. Number 8. Caesar Cocktail. The Caesar Cocktail, which is similar to a Bloody Mary, was conceived in 1969 by Calgary Inn bartender Walter Chell at the Calgary Inn in Calgary, Alberta. It's generally garnished with celery and other ingredients and created using vodka, clamato juice, spicy sauce, Worcestershire sauce, and spices. It is considered the national cocktail of Canada, and it's especially popular during the summer months. The original recipe is straightforward, although there are variants. Despite some historical controversies, the drink's popularity is growing, with over 400 million Caesars consumed in Canada each year. Number 7. Nanaimo Bars. Nanaimo bars are a popular Canadian treat with 3 layers: a crumbly chocolate cake foundation, a middle layer of yellow buttercream frosting laced with custard powder, and a dark chocolate top layer. The first recipe for Nanaimo bars was published in the 1952 Women's Auxiliary of the Nanaimo Hospital Cookbook. Sue Mendelssohn started serving the cookie at her Vancouver cafe, The Lazy Gourmet, in the 1970s, and it quickly became famous. Nanaimo bars are now marketed across Canada and are a popular item on the Nanaimo Bar Trail, which promotes many varieties of the delicacy in the Vancouver Island municipality of Nanaimo. The dessert has become a staple of Canadian cuisine and a must-try for visitors to the country. Number 6. Bannock. Bannock is a fried or baked bread that's a mainstay in Canadian cuisine and has gained popularity across the country, from powwows to high-end restaurants. It's a simple, unleavened bread that can be prepared in a variety of ways. The recipe for bannock was most likely brought to Canada by Scottish fur traders in the 18th or 19th century, but there is evidence that indigenous peoples developed a pre-colonial form called sablil. Bannock has become a staple of indigenous culinary tradition, particularly among the Métis in Western Canada. Bannock is now available in a variety of forms, including sliders, tacos, burgers, and even pigs in blankets. It's also available in premium restaurants that specialize in First Nations cuisine. Number 5. Sushi Pizza. Sushi pizza is a Japanese-inspired cuisine that features a fried rice patty topped with salmon sashimi, spicy mayonnaise, tobiko, flying fish roe, green onions, and on occasion, avocado slices. It's a popular dish in Canada, notably in Toronto, and is frequently served at all-you-can-eat sushi restaurants and mid-priced sushi restaurants. It is not a real Japanese dish, but is a fantastic starting place for sushi enthusiasts. Sushi purists despise the dish, while fans of sushi pizza adore its layers of texture and flavor. The sushi pizza's origins are unknown, but it's thought to have been invented in Toronto in the early 1990s at a restaurant called Nami. Sushi pizza, despite its controversial character, has become a popular and distinctive meal to try for visitors visiting Canada. Number 4. Pea meal bacon sandwich. When it comes to Canadian bacon, the pea meal bacon sandwich is king in Toronto, Canada. Pea meal bacon is a variety of Canadian bacon that's produced from lean, boneless pork loin instead of the more conventional back bacon. The yellow pea flour or pea meal used to cover the bacon gives the dish its name. Typically, the sandwich is made with a thick slice of pea meal bacon on fluffy Kaiser bread, with the bacon piled high and the roll covered with condiments like mustard and ketchup. Additions like lettuce, tomato, and cheese are possible in some iterations. Toronto is home to a wide variety of diners, delis, and restaurants, each of which serves its version of the city's famous pea meal bacon sandwich. It's become a symbol of Toronto's culinary identity and is often regarded as a must-try for tourists. Number 3. Butter tart. The butter tart is a well-loved Canadian delicacy and a staple of the Canadian culinary canon. Famous for their decadent flavor, these sugar pies include a flaky pie crust filled with a sweet filling of butter, sugar, syrup, and an egg. Butter tarts have been around since the early days of French colonization in Quebec, when local ingredients were used by young women to produce the first iteration of what would become today's popular dessert. For years, bakers have been split on whether or not to include raisins in butter tarts, with some opting to follow the traditional recipe which calls for currants. The province of Ontario plays host to several butter tart celebrations and tours, and the dessert has become a staple of Canadian cuisine. Despite the debate over the filling's consistency and what nuts to use, butter tarts remain a favorite among Canadians and visitors alike. Number 2. Montreal Smoked Meat Sandwich. In Canada, the Montreal Smoked Meat Sandwich stands out as a local favorite. Served between two slices of rye bread and doused in hot mustard, this sandwich is fashioned from thinly sliced beef. Beef brisket is smoked in an Eastern European style and seasoned with a variety of spices. The Ottoman Empire is credited with developing a cured meat product called pastrama, which served as the inspiration for the modern method of smoking meat. Several of the many Jewish immigrants to New York and Montreal carried with them a fondness for pastrama from Romania. This regional speciality eventually evolved into New York's signature pastrami, and in Montreal, into the smoked meat sandwich. Although the Montreal smoked meat sandwich is most commonly associated with Schwartz's Deli, there are many other excellent options in the city. Number 1. Poutine. Poutine is a dish made of French fries, gravy, and fresh cheese curds, and it's a popular food to try when visiting Canada for the first time. It originated in Quebec in the late 1950s and became popular in Montreal in the 1980s. The most common creation myths are set in Warwick and Drummondville, both towns in Quebec. It's essential to use fresh cheese curds to get the distinctive squeak that defines poutine. Poutine is now a global phenomenon, with many high-end restaurants across Canada serving it, and Poutine Week is held annually in Montreal. Poutine has a few different origin stories, but most people credit its creation to a diner owner in Warwick, Quebec, named Fernand Lachance. He famously commented that the dish would make a damn mess when a customer requested fries with cheese curds on top, but the addition of gravy helped to create the poutine we know today. And with that, we are at the end of our video. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss an update. If you have any suggestions for future videos or topics you'd like to see us cover, let us know in the comments below. We're always open to new ideas and feedback from our viewers. Until next time, safe and happy travels.